I don't want to keep it too long, but yeah, let me bring this down. So we try to work very, very hard this week to make things happen, at least a minimal set of things happen. And we thought it might be worth and right for all the effort these guys did to at least do a demo at the end of this very tough working week.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
so we'll just go through the demo of what we achieved till now, okay? And then we'll talk about the status of what has been done, what's in progress, and what needs to still be done, okay? Okay, so let me move forward. Okay, so here is the story we have in place, okay? We have, I guess you guys understand that for reasons of time, we didn't have much time to put together a good set of slides, but, and a great topology, but this should be enough representative, hopefully. So we have a four open flow switches, okay, controlled by one ONOS system. And then attached to these switches, we have two routers, two external routers, two different autonomous systems. And then on top of ONOS, we run our route server. So basically what you know as the NIP, okay? So on top, for the first time, we ran two services, SDNIP and VPLS. This is the first good news. SDNIP and VPLS, finally, they work together. The second news is that for the first time, all the routers, which seems a trivial thing, but it's not, they run on different, they send in packets using tags, VLAN tags. So this was, again, seems a small thing, but it wasn't possible till today and required us to use things like the postfix firewall, the tagging mode or complex thing on the enabled by the postfix firewall and so on. And this let us reject lots of deployments that finally we can do, thanks to this thing, okay? So specifically in this topology, the two routers, one is on VLAN 200, sending in packets on VLAN 200, the other one on VLAN 100, and we will see that we can do the proper translation between the VLAN. And also our BGP speaker uses VLAN 3500. So each of the devices connected is on the different VLAN, and now the intent framework can support the correct translations. Second thing we will show, as I said, is the first version of VPLS. Again, here the news is that can work together with SDNIP. In the specific case, the router has a second interface for layer 2 connectivity. It could be also other hosts in the network. And they are using both VLAN 500, and that's why for now VPLS connect them together. Okay? It knows that two hosts are using the same VLAN tags and connect them at layer 2. So we'll see two pings. Okay? So, any question, by the way, online or here?
So, because of this now, what kind of deployments become possible that were not possible before? And I thought your biggest concern was you were not comfortable with deployments.
Yeah. Well, there are different things, right? The first one is deployments that we've already done that always ask to have to provide layer 2 as a unique mechanism to provide layer 2 and layer 3 connectivity. Before this wasn't possible, now it is. So the next step, for example, with Geronimo in AMLight, we will immediately move forward to deploy VPLS and SDNIP in the production network there. We will do the same in the Giant network. We can now deploy in Japan on their testbed on JJNX. I have a list of 10 guys that with these are unlocked by the deployment. Because the main reason is that these testbeds share the resources. And if you cannot control VLAN, you won't be able to run there. Mm-hmm. Right? Okay, say that. Here we are. Yeah, I made it just larger. So I already deployed ONOS, and I can show you just the configuration. No applications are active right now, okay? So, but you can see here that I have two interfaces, okay, in the main configuration of ONOS. Two for SDNIP, VLAN 100, VLAN 200, and two for VTLS with VLAN 500, okay? So now what I do is just, I activate SDNIP. So it's a very simple configuration. App activate SDNIP. Activated. We wait to receive the route. This is the BGP. Okay, we receive the route. Here I have the two routers. I try to ping from one router to the other. It pings. It does all the translation. Okay. And I can also show you that we receive packets tagged with a VLAN. Okay. So if you see here, but the field VLAN is set to the current VLAN. Right. And then second application, VPLS. Active. So also here. Takes a second to establish the circuit after the first ping. And also the layer 2 connectivity between the two hosts on the same device is active. Okay. So as you see here, we are pinging from is the same layer 3 network, of course. Okay. So you can see that I'm pinging from 100, 100, 100, 1 to 100, 100, 102. Using the layer 2 circuit in the network. In SDNIP, instead, when I, these are two different networks. And it goes through the routing. And both the pings. Okay. Okay, so this is the short demo for today, but lots of other things are inside Garrett. So this was just a very small part of the work we did. And here is a summary of what's going on, okay? So what we saw was run together with VLS and SDNIP, enable VLAN packet tagging in SDNIP, thanks to Jono and then the implementations we did in some of the applications, we can use now the new neighbor resolution service. Also called before proxy R, which is completely better because we share lots of code and we don't have more code duplication. There are lots of benefits in it. Along the path, we fix lots of bugs that we found
bugs
out.
Did what? Bugs in what part?
In 10 frame. So just how many disasters? This afternoon was like crazy. Event framework, proxy R applications, southbound. Now we found one for ICMP packets, either that mismatch. We found any kind of bug in the stack.
Voila.
So the good news is that we picked up. So.
That's great. But tell me something, sir. I thought when we had the conversation about this whole brigade and what the scope is, I thought there was some significant chunk about intent framework and you were kind of wanting to. And needed Brian's help and all of that. So all that has been addressed, or you took shortcuts?
No, no shortcuts. So that means that
I'm surprised that
So the code that we developed, and hopefully the developers here agree. I'm looking at the face of one of them and of John and Brian. But the code that these guys developed is code that has quality, right? It's not code without tests or not hacks that just went being a rush into the code, into the
Good, sir. I mean, very good to know that. So, but I thought that some intent framework needed to evolve or change, or I don't remember the specific, but remember there were a lot of discussion and how much time Brian will have to So, but all of that is done, and it was done with that. Okay. Wow. That's a phenomenal accomplishment, because I'm remembering the discussion, not the specifics, but the discussion about the amount of effort and
yes.
what it takes. So.
So there are many parts, of course, that we need to touch. The first part was to enable this first use case of BPLS and SBNIP, which was like the initial core of the discussion. And all these modifications have been already done. There are other things to simplify our life in the future that are needed, absolutely. And you can see this in progress, talking about the intent framework.
Mm-hmm.
One.
So the thing is, for the types of intents that are being used in these two applications, the modifications that were needed to support them have been done. Now, to support a more generic type of intent that other applications may throw, there's still some work that's going on to continue those. But we at least have sort of a path in the direction we want to go. Some of these guys over here have been helpful in driving that forward.
Yes, I guess that maybe in any case this would have been the right thing to do, to start with few and then implement them and
yeah.
then learn from that and then generalize it, right?
Yeah.
In that sense, probably it was very good. Okay, excellent. Okay.
So what is going on right now, talking about the intent framework, we are introducing the notion of bandwidth reservation and enforcement in the intent framework. So till now, application that wanted to create, to enforce bandwidth, we're doing that without using the intent framework. The intent
mm-hmm.
framework didn't support meters or you couldn't reserve bandwidth between
yeah,
A and B.
You could express your requirement, but we didn't have a mechanism to enforce it.
To enforce it, yeah. So now, for example, Ally, she's doing that. She's helping us with that. We are introducing, and here I'm making a very long story, very short, encapsulation support. Right now, encapsulation for intent will support just for a very specific type of intent. But now we want to implement a general logic for all the intent types. So we'll automatically inherit encapsulation, which is a must have for networks, carrier networks, of course. So this is coming as well, and the modifications are in progress with them. With BPLS, very good things are going on. So BPLS, basically, we are adding, till now, you saw in this demo that we can connect points that have top in the same VLAN. Now, we, through the CLI, and the code is almost finished by the guys of NCPU, you'll be able to create the network, a virtual network, basically, I call it virtual network, and associate interfaces that use different tags, different VLANs to that network. So you slice your network, basically. And this is a very big change, because that gives you the flexibility to do whatever you want, to ask whatever resources you want at layer 2, and BPLS will support also the bandwidth reservation. So basically, you will be able to connect at layer 2 whatever multipoint you want, enforcing also the bandwidth, using whatever type of VLAN tags or in future MPLS tags at the edge. And plus doing encapsulation in the core. And this is a big deal, right? Because other applications need this primitive. And so what we are doing is introducing on top of BPLS a Java API that other applications can rely on and can require these basic resources at layer 2. So
I think I may not understand the details, but I would love to follow up with you and see,
yes.
Draw it on the whiteboard and then be able to understand
sure.
the implications of that. But yeah, I agree, it seems like a big deal to be able
yes.
to do that. And how it, okay, but I think we should follow
yeah.
up on that. Yeah.
And so one example, and here I connect to the to-do, I say that on top of BPLS, we will expose some sort of interfaces for other applications to use these functionalities. We will support an application that Giant with Ally, driven by Ally, did till now, called it Bandwidth on Demand. Unfortunately, this application, for the limitations we had on our side, was kind of separate from all the stack and from the intent framework and so on. Not sure you're familiar with NSI. Basically, all the research network by default to create multi-domain connectivity, they use this standard interface to the outside world, that is called NSI. So someone come from outside and say, I want a circuit, basically, between a circuit and a year two circuit, between different points in your network, enforcing certain bandwidth. So this is an example of application that we rely on top of VPLS. And at the top, we'll export, we'll expose the NSI API, right? So this will be part of our demo in November at the ONOS Build event.
Oh, great.
So it's not something that we want to do in like an year, 2 years, right? Something that we want to make it happen for all of us in the next month.
Wow. Okay.
So all this code, 99% of this code still in progress, is in Garrett with unit tests. We went already through multiple reviews, and hopefully we'll be merged soon officially into the master. It's not in a separate repository, it's not asked. So that's it, I guess. Yeah.
Very good, congratulations.
Yeah.
Wow.